What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy, Cam, ATL. Shout out to the DFS squad. Shout out to everybody watching this video right now. Drop a like down below because I already know you're going to love it. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. The winner of last week's $50 giveaway is DJ Moore. DJ Moore, congratulations. Hit me up on Twitter at Cam_ATL. Or email me dfssquadcam@gmail.com so I can get that PayPal and send you over that 50. As you know, as always, we're doing another 50. I'm giving another 50 away to a commenter down below in the comment section next Sunday. So comment anything, like the video. We need over 200 plus likes on every video. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I'm adding a little extra on top of the 50 this week. On top of the $50, I'm giving away a free membership to the entire season for the MLB cheat sheet on our website, greenlightdfs.com. That's a huge value. That's over $300+ value for free that the winner's going to be winning on Sunday when I announce. So spam up that like. Let's get as many likes as we can on every video. Comment anything in the comment section to enter your name into the giveaway. For every video you comment on, that just enters your name more. Okay, so it's always better. Subscribe to the channel because when I choose the winner, I will be making sure you're subscribed. So make sure you're subscribed. You get an entire season of the MLB cheat sheet, give you an upper hand against the competition all season long for the free as well as $50. So not only am I giving you the whole season package for the cheat sheet, but I'm giving you $50 on top of that because I love you. All right, that's it, because I fucking love you, all right? Starting off at pitcher, let's get straight into it, man. Starting off at pitcher, I'm going Blake Snell. Blake Snell's got some good strikeout upside, man, okay? Especially against this Texas lineup without Elvis Andrews. They have a 21% strikeout rate versus lefties. This Texas lineup only has a 138 ISO versus lefties. You got to think about it, like, the power in this Texas lineup, Mazzara, Gallo, Sin-Soo Choo, those guys are all lefties, okay? Blake Snell takes away some of that damage that they're going to give towards him, okay? He strikes out 26% of lefties, only holds him to a .033 ISO. He limits hard contact like a monster. Only allows a 2.266 wOBA as well. So he limits ISO to damn near non-existent versus lefties, and the wOBA is very low as well. Versus righties, he still only has a 152 ISO, which is still very low. He strikes out 22% of the righties he faces. So as you can see, the strikeout potential is there. Tropicana Field is a friendly park for pitchers. Tampa Bay is favored to win this game here. I fully expect Tampa Bay's offense to do enough versus Moore to go ahead and get Snell the W as well, and some very good strikeout upside versus Texas offense. All the pitchers who have been facing them since Andrews left has been absolutely dominating this Texas lineup. So take advantage. Blake Snell at only 78. He's got some great upside. Very, very solid play today against Texas. Now, next up, we got Jaime Garcia at home in Toronto, taking on Kansas City. Now, Toronto is a huge favor in this one. Skoglund should get rocked around by Toronto's offense. Kansas City's lineup has a 23% strikeout rate versus lefties, and they are only hitting a 134 ISO versus lefties. So that hard contact is limited, which keeps away those home runs that really tear you apart, those earned runs. And then you got Jaime Garcia, who's got some decent strikeout stuff too, especially versus lefties. He strikes out 23% of lefties, only 18% of righties, but he limits hard contact. Only 151 ISO to righties and a 137 ISO to lefties. So he holds that hard contact down. He does a good job. A lot of that Kansas City power due to Moustakas is on the left side. That limits them. That makes it very, very good for Jaime Garcia. I love Jaime at 71 against this Kansas City offense that should strike out in bunches. I fully expect Toronto to beat around Skoglund, so I'll take Jaime Garcia at 71. At first base, I'm spending up for my boy, Freddie Freeman, against Aaron Nola. This dude's been, he has crushed Aaron Nola. First game of the year, he actually faced Aaron Nola, and he dropped 26 DraftKings points first game of the year. Okay, Not only that, but he's at home in a very hitter-friendly ballpark, and the wind is blowing out to left field at 14 miles per hour. Okay, so that's better for the right-handed bats, but obviously Freddie Freeman's a guy who, I mean, especially with the type of matchup that you have here, you just play him. At 5,200, I mean, he's only, what, 300, 400 more than Smoke. I'll take that. I'd rather Freddie Freeman, especially with us taking Snell and Garcia. It allows for us to pretty much get any bats we want. So Freddie Freeman at 52 against Nola, great situation, man, because on top of everything, lefty on righty matchup, he crushes righties. The wind is in his favor in this one. And the Philly bullpen is bottom in the league versus left-handed bats. So even once Nola leaves, Freeman's going to be facing somebody that's bad versus lefties. So take advantage of that. Freddie Freeman for a big game at 52. In the outfield, I'm spinning up here too. Rhys Hoskins at 54. Like I said, this is very good. The weather in Atlanta is very good for right-handed bats. It's blowing out to left at 14 miles per hour. Rhys Hoskins, we all know, has some great power, and he's got a good solid history versus Tejeron, hitting a 459 WOBA and a 250 ISO, okay? Rhys Hoskins is one of those reverse splits guys. He hits a 311 ISO and a 428 WOBA versus right-handed pitching, okay? This should be a great game for Rhys Hoskins, and like I said, because we have the good, solid, cheaper options at pitcher today, it allows for us to spend up at batter, and we can get us a Rhys Hoskins. Now, for value, I'm going to go Steve Pierce at 3,100. Now, this dude's been batting at the top of this Toronto batting order. Not only that, but they're projected to score over 5 runs against Skoglund. This is a lefty-on-righty matchup. Pierce is very good versus lefties, hitting a 242 ISO and a 341 WOBA. Now, the best part about this is Skoglund is absolutely dreadful versus righties, giving up a 265 WOBA and a 265 ISO and a 468 WOBA. Pretty much every righty that faces Skoglund gets on base. So stack up Toronto. That's definitely one of my moves I'll be going with. Stack up some Toronto, especially the righties versus Skoglund. Smoke is in play, obviously. And then get some of those Atlanta bats and Philly bats with that wind blowing out to left. The righty bats in that game have a little bit of an uptick in value because of that wind helping that push that ball out of there. Okay? But yeah, Steve Pierce, amazing matchup. And on top of that, man, Kansas City's bullpen is garbage versus right-handed bats. So they're bottom of the league versus right-handed bats. So it's one of those situations again, which is something you definitely want to look at. You want to look at the strength of bullpens for these teams because, you know, say your batter's going to be facing a guy that you're really not too excited to play against. You know, you're really not too excited to start a batter against. If the bullpen's horrible, once that guy leaves in the sixth inning, you got 3 innings, at least probably 2 at-bats. Maybe 1 to 2 at-bats that he's going to be facing a horrible pitcher versus a bad bullpen. Okay, in this situation, he's got Skoglund, who's horrible versus righties. And then once Skoglund leaves, another pitcher who's horrible versus righties is going to come in. So it should be a field day for all 3 of our bats. And our pitchers are in great matchups. Blake Snell, Jamie Garcia, Freddie Freeman, Rhys Hoskins, and Steve Pierce is the high five. This is going to be a big day. Let's get it. Go to greenlightdfs.com to join the squad for the cheat sheet. Comment anything down in the comment section below for your chance to win the MLB season cheat sheet for the free, along with $50 on Sunday. Let's get it. I'm out.